Hi students, welcome to this session of fluid mechanics. Dear students, you know that we have discussed little bit last class viscous flow, where we have seen the flow of a viscous fluid through a pipe, how we can calculate the velocity distribution, how we can show the velocity distribution of a particular fluid flow. Okay, and we have seen some velocity, how we can calculate velocity, average velocity, maximum velocity. Okay, that we have discussed. Then we have discussed how we can calculate the discharge, and what we have seen, discharge Q is equal to g integration 0 to r, okay, dq, and it is equal to, ultimately, if whatever the formula we have got, 0 to r minus 1 by 4 mu del p by del x into r square minus r square into 2 pi r dr. So if you are calculating this formula, you will be getting q is equal to what, pi by 8 mu minus del p by del x into r to the power 4. Okay, and from this discharge, okay, from this discharge you can easily find out the u bar, that is your average velocity. Average velocity to q is equal q by area, discharge by area. Okay, and what we have seen, the ratio of maximum velocity to average velocity is equal to 2. Clear? So that we have discussed last class. Now today we will be going to discuss about the drop of pressure for a given length of pipe. But before coming to the discussion, let us introduce myself. I am Dhiraj Mondal, Assistant Professor, JIS College of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering Department. You can connect me. This is my YouTube channel, DM Study Center. This is the link. You can connect here. You can subscribe my channel, and you can press the bell icon to get every day notification. Any kind of query, you can call me here, and this is my email ID. You have to submit all the assignment here, my Facebook page, in case if you want to have, you get, and that means any doubt you, if you are having, then you can contact me. This is also my WhatsApp number. Okay, now 2020 admission open in JIS College of Engineering. Admission is open 2020 in Mechanical Engineering Department. In case if you want to join here, or if you want to see the college infrastructure, you may visit. This is the contact number and official website and email ID. And for Mechanical Engineering Department, any query you can call here also. Okay, so you know that viscous flow, last class we have discussed this part, this slide also discussed. Here we have seen how we can calculate the particular shear stress, and this is the formula, minus tau is equal to minus del p by del x into r by 2. This formula is, I hope it is well known to you. And next is your velocity distribution and shear stress distribution. This diagram you have seen. Why this is parabola? Because this is satisfying the formula of parabola, that is your y square is equal to 4ax. Okay, next u is equal to this, and you can see this is the maximum velocity minus 1 by 4 mu del p by del x into r square. Okay, and discharge you can find out from this formula. This is the discharge, and this is the average velocity. This is your average velocity, and the ratio of u max by u bar is equal to 2. So I hope it is clear. And now if you are having any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section also. Okay, drop of pressure for a given length L of a pipe. So drop of pressure U bar, and also we have seen that this is the formula of drop of pressure. U bar is the average velocity, and the formula, you know, this is the formula. So already we have seen. So U bar is equal to this. Now, or we can write del P by del X is equal to 8 mu U bar by R square, because we have to calculate the drop of pressure. How much amount of pressure is dropping from position 1 to position 2. If it is traveling from position 1 to position 2, then you can see this is your length from this point. This is your x1 and this is your x2. Okay, and this length is your L. And let us consider in this point 1, section 1, the pressure is your P1, and in the point 2, pressure is your P2. Clear? Now, if this equation, I am integrating this equation, what we'll see? That dp is equal to 8 mu U bar by R square into dx. Am I right? And now if I am integrating this part, what will be the limit? The pressure, see, this is the minus, means pressure is changing and decreasing. So what we can see, that the limit is your maximum, it is your pressure here P1, and this is your P2. So what is the limit? P2 limit T 2 to 1 delta P is equal to 2 to 1 this 8 mu bar by R square into dx. Okay, so this is the limit. That means it is traveling from position 1 to position 2 and pressure is decreasing. Okay, because the negative sign is telling that pressure is decreasing. So if I am just integrating, what is the integration of dp? It is your only p, and limit, put the limit p1 minus p2. Integration of dx is equal to x, put the limit x1 minus x2. So ultimately what we have got, this is the equation, delta p is equal to 8 mu u bar l by r square. Very very important formula if you when you are going to solve the numerical. And R is equal to what? R is equal to D by 2, you know. Radius is equal to diameter by time. And X1 minus X2 is equal to L. So that is why this part is written L. Because this is your L. X2 minus X1. Okay. X2 minus X1 is equal to L. Now, if I am putting the value of R is equal to D by 2, we will be getting the P1 minus P2, or delta P is equal to 32 mu U bar L by D square. Okay, where P1 minus P2 is the drop of pressure. Clear? So what we have seen, loss of pressure head, we know that what H, loss of pressure head HF is equal to P1 minus P2 by rho g, because pressure head, you know, P by rho g is the pressure head. So if the P1 is the pressure and in the point 1 and P2 is the pressure in the point 2, then what is the pressure head, loss of pressure head? P1 minus P2 by rho g, P1 by rho g minus P2 by, so ultimately it is written here. So if I am putting, that means if this equation and this equation equal, then what we will see? We will see del P1 minus P2 by rho g is equal to HF is equal to 32 mu VL, V bar, that is your average velocity, VL by rho ZD square. So this equation is known as Hazen-Poiseuille formula. Okay, what is the formula? Delta P is equal to 32 mu V or U bar L by rho g d square. Now this rho g you can write w, small w. Okay, and it is equal to p1 minus p2 by rho g. Clear? So this is all about the Poiseuille formula. So this is how we can calculate the pressure drop. Now let us solve some numerical. Here in this question it is asked that the crude oil, first of all go through the problem. A crude oil of velocity or viscosity 0.97 poise and relative density 0.9 is flowing through a horizontal pipe of diameter 100 millimeter and of length of 10 meter. Circulate the difference, calculate the difference of pressure at the two ends of the pipe if 100 kg of oil is collected in a tank in 30 seconds. So what we have to calculate? Calculate the difference of pressure at two ends. The pressure difference you need to calculate. Okay. And what is the condition given? You know that mu is equal to, it is given 0.97 poise. And you know that if it is given poise is the unit, CGS unit of the dynamic viscosity. You need to convert it in terms of SI unit. So 1 poise is equal to 1 by 10 newton second per meter square, that we know. So that is why it is written 0.97 by 10, that is your 0.097 newton second per meter square. Relative density is given 0.9. rho or density, relative, once relative density is given then you can calculate the density. We know that relative density is equal to density of liquid by density of water. So density of water is 1000, so that is why rho L is equal to s is equal to 0.9 into 1000. So that is why it is written here rho naught or density is equal to 900 kg per meter cube. Clear? The diameter of the pipe d is given here 100 mm, this is the diameter, and length is, L is given 10, am I right? Now length given, diameter given, mass of the oil collected, so mass is equal to 100 kg, t is equal to 30 seconds. Okay, t is equal to what? 30 seconds. Now we know that a formula delta p is equal to 32 mu v a mu e u var by d square. Rho g and rho g cancel out, so that is why this can be written. So this u is what? Average velocity. Now you need to find out the average velocity also. So you know average velocity is equal to what? Q by area, then that means discharge by area. And mass of oil per second, what is the mass of oil per second? 100 kg mass per second, 30 second. So that is your 10 by 3 or 0.33. So this is the mass of oil per second. Okay, here it is written, if the 100 kg of oil is collected in a tank in 30 seconds. Okay, so this is the mass. Now you know that mass is equal to what? Mass is equal to what? You know rho is equal to m by v. So mass is equal to, here mass flow rate, so mass flow rate is equal to what? Rho into V by T, mass flow rate, and V by T is equal to Q, so rho into Q. So that is here written. So rho mass, already you know that this kg, this 100 by 30 kg per second, and this is also equal to rho into q, rho naught into q, that is. So 100 by 30 is equal to 90 into q. So q is equal to this, that is the discharge. Once you have got discharge, you can find out u bar. So q by area. So area diameter, you know, pi by 4 d square, you know, q, you know. So 0.471 meter per second. 0.471 meter per second is the average velocity. Am I right? Okay. Now, this is the average velocity. Now, here you just put all the value. Now, here basically one more thing. We need to find out whether the fluid is laminar or turbulent in nature. For laminar or viscous flow, Reynolds number Re is equal to what? It is basically less than 2000 if it is laminar. For laminar or viscous flow, the Reynolds number is less than 2000. Now you have to calculate the Reynolds number. Reynolds number is equal to rho Vd by nu, nothing to discuss anymore. You know it is inertia by viscous force. Inertia by viscous force. So this formula you know. So rho is equal to rho naught here. V is equal to V u bar, that is your average velocity. Diameter you know, mu you know. So Reynolds number is equal to 436. That means it is less than 2000, means we can say that it is a laminar in nature. The fluid is laminar in nature. Okay. So now put the value. Delta P is equal to 32 mu u bar L by d square. So you know that mu value, the value of mu is given, u bar already I have calculated, L is given, d is also given. So ultimately the pressure drop is equal to what? 0.1462 newton per centimeter square. This is all about the drop of pressure delta P. Okay. So I hope this problem is clear, because this type of problem you will see in your final exam. And basically everywhere you need to find out the Reynolds number. To if Reynolds number is less than 2000, it is called laminar. If it is your 2000 to 4000, it is called your transition state. And if it is greater than 4000, then it is called turbulent fluid, turbulent flow. Okay. So based on that, you can recognize that which type of flow is this and what will be the loss of energy when the fluid is flowing from one place to another place. Okay. Now, next, 9.2. An oil of viscosity 0.1 newton second per meter square and relative density 0.9 is flowing through a circular pipe of diameter 50 mm and of length 300 meter. The rate of flow of fluid through the pipe is 3.5 liter per second. Find the pressure drop in a length of 300 meter and also the shear stress at the pipe wall. So you need to find out the shear stress and also the pressure drop. Okay. So first of all, pause the video and solve yourself. If you are able to solve this, no problem. That means one step ahead. Okay, koi problem nahi, bas solve karte jao. And if you haven't solved the problem, then see the solution. So pause the video. So I hope you have solved the problem. Now see the solution, how we can calculate. First of all, the procedure is what you need to put all the value which are given. So viscosity is given 0.1 newton second per meter square. relative density given, you can easily find out the density of the well. So 900 kg per meter cube. Diameter given, length given, discharge given. What do you need to find out? We have to find out the pressure drop, P1 minus P2, shear stress at pipe wall, that means tau naught. So if it is your pipe, then in this pipe wall, what is the shear stress that we need to find out? Clear? And we will see that how much, that means the shear stress like this, the velocity is a shear stress distribution function like this, and the velocity distribution function like the parabola. So we will see that in the let us see what will be the shear stress. Now pressure drop, you know this formula, keep it in your mind everywhere it is needed. 32 mu VL by D square. V means here basically U bar, that is your average velocity, and U bar is equal to what? Q by area. So put the value, you will be getting the U bar, that is your average velocity. Reynolds number we can find out. Reynolds number is equal to rho Vd by mu. Rho is given, V already you have found out. Okay, so rho Vd by mu. So this is the Reynolds number, that means the fluid is laminar in nature. Okay, as the Reynolds number is less than 2000, the flow is viscous. Okay, viscous or laminar, you can see. Viscous fluid or laminar fluid. Now put the value. Delta P is equal to this formula. So ultimately the answer is your 68.43 Newton per centimeter square. So this is your delta P. Clear? Now shear stress at the pipe wall. What is the shear stress at the pipe wall? We know that this formula of tau is equal to minus del P by del X into R by 2. So at the pipe wall, R is equal to R, because if it is your pipe and this is the axis line, so R is calculated from the center point. Okay, so this is your R and total is your R. So here basically from this line, this is your radius R, capital R. So that is why it is written tau naught is equal to minus del P by del X R by R, and it is equal to what? Minus del P by del X minus del P by del X is equal to minus del P minus, if you are putting the limit, see the del P is equal to what? P2 minus P1, that is your pressure difference, and minus, and this one is your X2 minus X1, and X2 minus X1 is equal to L, and if we are neglecting this minus part, so P1 minus P2, okay, by L, am I right? So what I can write right now, this is the this is by the help of this we can write like this, and P1 minus P2 is equal to this pressure drop is you know already have got, this is the pressure drop, and put the value, and 300 is the length. So R is equal to what now? So R is equal to D by 2, so it is equal to 0.2025. So tau is equal to, now put the value of tau. Tau naught is equal to minus del P by del X, and that I have got from this equation 2280.98, and R by 2, R is equal to 0.025 by 2. So 28.5 Newton per meter square is the shear stress at the pipe wall. Okay. Okay, so this is the shear stress at the pipe wall. I hope it is clear. In case if you want to draw the velocity distribution and the shear stress distribution diagram, so this is a shear stress distribution diagram and this is the velocity distribution, like a parabola, and you will see the maximum shear stress will occur in the pipe wall. ओके नाउ लेट अस सी नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम, प्रॉब्लम नंबर 9.3। ए लेमिनर फ्लो इज टेकिंग प्लेस इन ए पाइप ऑफ डायमीटर 200 mm, द मैक्सिमम वेलोसिटी इज 1.5 मीटर पर सेकेंड, फाइंड द मीन वेलोसिटी एंड द रेडियस एट व्हिच दिस ऑकर, ऑल्सो कैलकुलेट द वेलोसिटी एट 4 सेंटीमीटर फ्रॉम द वॉल ऑफ द पाइप। सो अगेन पॉज द वीडियो एंड सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम योर सेल्फ, देन सी द सोल्यूशन। सो हियर बेसिकली वॉट इज आस्किंग, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द गिवन डेटा इज योर डी इज इक्वल टू 200 mm और 2.2 मीटर, यू मैक्स इज इक्वल टू 1.5 मीटर पर सेकेंड, यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट द मीन वेलोसिटी दैट इज योर मीन वेलोसिटी दैट इज योर यू बार, रेडियस एट व्हिच यू बार ऑकर, सो व्हाट इज द रेडियस वेयर द यू बार ऑकरिंग दैट यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट, एंड द वेलोसिटी एट 4 सेंटीमीटर फ्रॉम द दैट मीन्स आर इज इक्वल टू 4 सेंटीमीटर, वेयर आर इज इक्वल टू 4 सेंटीमीटर एट दैट टाइम व्हाट इज द वेलोसिटी दैट यू नीड टू फाइंड, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फार्मूला, a very very important problem, and the formula, the all the formula, application of formula you will see here. So first of all mean velocity, you know that average velocity is equal to maximum velocity by time by 2, so that we know last class I have seen. So u max by u bar we can write u max by u bar is equal to 2, and u max is equal to 1.5, that is given 1.5 meter per second, and u bar you need to find out, so is equal to 2 means u bar is equal to 0.75 meter per second, so that is very easy. So mu bar, once you have got maximum velocity, you can find out the average velocity is equal to 0.75 meter per second. So radius at which u bar occurs, dekho radius एट व्हिच यू बार, दैट यहाँ पर क्या बोला गया, मीन वेलोसिटी रेडियस एट व्हिच द यू बार ऑकर एंड वेलोसिटी ऑफ द एट 4 सेंटीमीटर फ्रॉम द वॉल। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रेडियस एट व्हिच यू बार ऑकर दैट मीन्स योर एवरेज वेलोसिटी ऑकरिंग, सो यू नो दैट द फॉर्मूला यू इज इक्वल टू 1 by -1/4 म्यू डेल पी बाय डेल एक्स आर स्क्वायर माइनस आर स्क्वायर, इजंट इट? नाउ 1/4 म्यू इट इज कॉन्स्टेंट, डेल पी बाय डेल एक्स आर स्क्वायर, इफ आई एम टेकिंग कॉमन आर स्क्वायर देन 1 - r² बाय स्मॉल आर स्क्वायर बाय कैपिटल आर स्क्वायर, एम आई राइट? नाउ यू मैक्स इज इक्वल टू -1/4 म्यू into del p by del x into r square, can I write? Because already we know, so these are the formula. Now put the value here, basically you can see this formula means here you can put, so u is equal to u max into 1 minus r square by r square, that we can write, because this is what it is, nothing but u max, that is your maximum velocity. Now put the value of r, so u bar, now the radius r with u is equal to u bar and u bar is equal to 0.75, so 0.75 is equal to 1.5, that is your u max, 1 minus r by d by 2, because r radius capital R is equal to d by 2 into r square whole square. So ultimately one unknown is there, you can see r is equal to, this is the after the calculation you will see r is equal to 70.7 millimeter, am I right? Now the velocity, what is the velocity at 4 centimeter from the wall, so r is equal to r minus 4, so r is equal to 10, you know, am I right? R is equal to 10 and 4 centimeter. Here basically R is equal to 10 means here you can see. You can see here. That the diameter is equal to 0.1 meter. So what is the r? R is equal to 0.1. Diameter is equal, r is equal to, here basically r is equal to 0.2 meter. So what is the d is equal to 0.2 meter. So what is the r? R is equal to 0.1 meter, and that is equal to 10 centimeter, isn't it? So that is written here. So r is equal to 10 centimeter minus 4 centimeter. So small r you can find out, 0.06 meter. So the velocity at radius 0.06 meter, what we can write, or the 4 centimeter from pipe wall is given as, you can see here, this is the r, capital R, and this is your small r. So at point r is equal to 0.06 meter, so you know that u max 1 minus r by r is r whole square. So this is the velocity, u is equal to u max 1 minus r by r is whole square in, okay. So if you are putting the value, you will be getting, this is your 1.5, 1 minus 0.36, so ultimately 0.96 meter per second is the correct answer. Am I right? So I hope it is clear. This is all about the viscous flow and through what we have discussed, drop of pressure for a given length and related numerical, very very important. Because in gate exam, in IAS exam, this type of question is asking, okay, and you need to solve. It is very very easy problem. Now next class we will be discussing about the flow of viscous fluid between two parallel plates. Let me see, if it is your two parallel plate, you can see, and the water is flowing. So what will be the viscosity, what will be the condition, what will be the u, that is your velocity at a particular point, what will be the average velocity, velocity distribution function, okay, then after the discharge, pressure drop, maximum velocity, average velocity, that will be discussed in the next class, okay. So I hope it is clear. Now before closing this video, let us discuss, the admission is open for 2020. In case any doubt, any query, you can call here or you can contact me. This is my contact number, okay. So today up to this, thank you for listening.